All right, well, welcome. We have Ryan Jacobson, the incoming president for the Fresno Rotary. So welcome, Ryan. Thanks for being here on the Spotlight.
I'm excited to be here, man. We're just, the clock's ticking, just a couple more weeks here and get the honor of taking over.
Absolutely, it's gonna be a fun year. So you are the Fresno County Farm Bureau. So tell us a little bit about your title and what you do there.
Yeah, so I'm CEO of the Fresno County Farm Bureau and just celebrated my 16th anniversary here. The Fresno County Farm Bureau is a nonprofit, non-governmental agency that essentially advocates for farmers and ranchers. And so as I tell everybody, it kind of blends my two loves of agriculture and politics. I think I like the agriculture side a whole lot more now than the political side. But nevertheless, I think I've been a decent advocate for trying to be a voice for our farmers and ranchers. This region is incredibly special when it comes to agriculture. And I'm so fortunate and lucky to be right in the heart of it here in Fresno.
Well, thank you. It's an important part of what you do for us here. I mean, the water and the food and all the resources, it's good to have those connections and be a support system as well.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So thank you. So how did you get started in Fresno Rotary? I mean, who brought you in? What's your experience? How did you now lead into being president?
Well, I'm still trying to figure out how I got here, and honestly, so quickly. So I've only been a Rotarian for about 8 years now, just shy of 8 years. My sponsor at the time was Dale Samoyan, and what led me there is I had actually been to several meetings over the previous to that. I mean, not necessarily as a potential member, but just as a invitee to come see some ag-related topics, some speakers. And I was actually involved in one of them before I was a Rotarian. It was actually an immigration one that had a panel of speakers talking about it. And then just Dale, I think, brought me on two or three times and was asked to be a member. And it was pretty much a no-brainer because I think like so many of our members absolutely love the programs, love the fellowship. And it was just a pretty easy choice to join this particular Rotary.
Yes. Yeah, I'm sure when you first walked in and you saw, people that you help every day, as well as all kinds of members of the community, it was pretty exciting. And it's a great opportunity to see them on Zoom now, too. So,
and I think it's no secret. I mean, we have a very strong Fresno State presence. During my time at Fresno State, I got both my bachelor's and master's there. I was also a two-time student body president and got to know a lot of faces over there that happened to coincide with this Rotary. So it was very nice to come back and see a lot of those folks that I hadn't seen for the previous decade since my Fresno State days.
Absolutely. Yeah, I'm a Fresno State grad as well, so. Yeah, go Bulldogs. So, and I know you're involved, I think, with the Fresno Chamber as well, and probably several other boards too. So thank you for your service.
Yeah, no, I'm very fortunate that, beyond my Farm Bureau hat, very involved in the water world, serve as the president of the board for the local Fresno Irrigation District, which is very critical to delivering water supplies both to the cities of Fresno and Clovis, as well as a huge area around them. Serve as a secretary treasurer of the Kings River Water Association, involved in, as you said, the chamber, local BizFed group, and just a whole host of other different organizations that not only come from the ag side, but also benefit the community. I mean, I'm a rarity today. I've lived every single day of my life in the same house, and I'm proud of that fact. Come from the little community of Easton, just south of town here. And so there's just a specialness to what we do around this community beyond agriculture. I'm so proud of what we do on the agriculture side. But this community is still a relatively small community, and just to have some phenomenal leaders, and so many of them are part of this Rotary, and that's why it's just been a natural fit to kind of bridge all those worlds there in one place at Fresno Rotary meetings on Monday.
Yes, great. Well, thank you for your service and reaching out to all the community as well. So July 1 is a fast approaching, and you're going to be president. So I know you've been working at this for a couple of years now. So just lead us off with maybe a couple little teasers. I know you got a couple things under wraps that we'll bring out in July. So tell us what's to come, some great fun things to look forward to.
Well, what to look forward to, obviously this has been such an unusual year. I mean, I give a ton of credit to President Todd and yourself and the whole host of the board and executive team that's kind of, had to figure all this out on the fly when it comes to the COVID situation. For those folks that haven't been president, there's a lot of work that goes on behind the scenes before you even get ready for your presidential year. And so it's been a busy year from there, but obviously you have all these goals and, aspirations. And a lot of that obviously came to a screaming halt in March when the COVID situation hit. And so been trying to pick up the pieces from there, kind of figuring out and how these puzzle pieces are going to all come together come July 1st. And fortunately, having a little more certainty going forward. I think we're all, you know, collectively, we're excited to come back together whenever that might be. I know it's not going to be necessarily real immediate, but when we do come back together, I think there's a lot of excitement I want to utilize and really harness that excitement into our upcoming year. You know, a big thing for me, and as I mentioned earlier, why I joined as a Rotarian is programming, the fellowship, you know, that's all, that's very near and dear to my heart, making sure that I continue that legacy of greatness that we have and making sure I even do what I can to strengthen that and continue to build upon it. You know, we've done some of the, our Rotarians have seen so far, we've made some changes to the way that we're funding, you know, community projects and club projects, trying to be as proactive as possible so that we can have more involvement in these community projects over the course of the year. There's just, there's a lot of excitement out there and just trying to, really collectively, you know, I don't have to really come into this club and lead. This organization is obviously full of leaders throughout it. It's just helping to, you know, provide my guidance and wherever I can assist and help and just get, you know, people all collectively going in the same direction there. But as we've seen through this COVID situation, this organization does incredible things for our community. And so it's a great time for us to, you know, like I said, even it's been difficult not seeing each other face to face. It's been great to really keep those connections alive via Zoom. And as we go forward, really try to be a great year for the 2020-21 year.
Absolutely. Well, good. Well, thank you. We're looking forward to having you lead our clubs on Mondays and appreciate that. So, well, thanks for meeting with Zoom today and have a great Father's Day. And to all the fathers out there, happy Father's Day too.
So. Absolutely. Thank you so much, Shanna. Yeah, everybody out there, happy Father's Day. I'll be enjoying it with my three little boys.
Excellent.